Hello there! Today we are going to talk about adversarial machine learning. No, Miss Coffee Bean, do not be afraid. Of course, we will discuss what adversarial attacks are, but also how to defend against them. So come on, be courageous! First thing that we need to know about adversarial machine learning is how to tell it apart from generative adversarial networks, okay? GANs are a class of models training in a non-cooperative way, hence the name adversarial. In GANs, the goal of the adversaries is to make the model stronger, so the game is well intended. On the other side, adversarial learning is the set of techniques that try to fool models by providing deceiving input. So here is a certain malevolence to the whole thing. In this video, we will focus on these bad boys here. And let's start with a notorious adversarial example. We look at these two images here. Miss Coffee Bean does not see any difference, do you? Well, there actually is a difference between these two pictures, and the difference is a tiny fraction of the magnitude of the noise here. While this difference is imperceptible to the human eye, it is making a huge difference for a CNN-based neural network. The same CNN predicts for the image on the left with quite some confidence that the image represents a panda. Well done! But on the image on the right, where we have added noise, the CNN thinks it's a gibbon. And this with an overwhelming confidence. How could this happen? This is an example of adversarial noise attack. The algorithm behind this noise attack is fairly simple, even though the name sounds very intimidating, fast gradient sine method. Here we explain it briefly. Remember, we train neural networks by stochastic gradient descent, in short SGD, in the following way. For finding the optimal parameters of the neural network to solve the problem at hand, we compute the so-called loss function. The loss function measures the difference between the current prediction of the network and the correct prediction, here panda. Of course, we want the difference between the current prediction and the ground truth to be as small as possible. Hence, we adapt our parameters of the network by minimizing the loss function. And stochastic gradient descent, SGD, comes in. By computing the gradient of the loss function with respect to the parameters, we know the direction in which the loss grows bigger. But we want to minimize it, so we move into the direction of the negative of the derivative in order to minimize the loss function. But this was SGD, which we employ when training the network to perform as best as it can. Only that now we are in the malevolent realm of adversarial attacks. So it is normal that fast gradient sine methods try to revert what SGD has done during training by moving into the direction of positive gradient, upwards, not downwards on the loss landscape. And instead of updating the weights, it updates the input itself, since the model itself now is given and fixed. In the normal fast gradient sine methods, this procedure is done once, but we can also perform it iteratively, like in this formula, to be sure one has moved away enough from a local optimum. This noise attack was an untargeted white box attack. Untargeted means that we manipulated the input such that the response of the network is anything but the true label. We just ensured that the network misclassifies the panda, mistaking it with something else. The opposite of an untargeted attack is, of course, a targeted one, where we want the network to misclassify the panda and to label it with a specific label, for example, gibbon and nothing else. And because all that the fast gradient sine method did was to move away untargeted from the correct label, the fast gradient sine method as presented here is untargeted, but this method can be also used in targeted attacks, of course, with a minor modification by computing the negative loss with respect to the target class instead of the positive loss of the true class. Done. White box means we have access to the model's parameters. For the fast gradient sine method, we do need this axis in order to be able to propagate gradients back to the input. In a black box attack, however, the attacker does not have access to the model. Let us think of an example, one from NLP perhaps. What about breaking a machine translation model by introducing noise such as misspellings or character swaps? Well, a paper from 2018 did exactly that and has proven that these changes, representing no challenges to human, broke the model without having access to it, so in a black box attack scenario. Examples of adversarial attacks are far too numerous and show how susceptible neural networks are to attacks, but also represent good tests from which researchers learn and interpret something from the failure cases. Some adversarial examples have very strong societal aspects and implications. Take for example this work that proves how easy it is to fool a neural network that detects persons, where all you need to fool it is to print yourself the right motive on a t-shirt. One has to think also about adversarial attacks for self-driving cars. Take this case, where inconspicuous changes to the stop signs make the neural vision system interpret the stop signs to be speed limits. Now, Miss Coffee Bean, we have seen only a tiny fraction of attacks. What do you say?
Let's defend.
Sure, let's start thinking about how to defend adversarial attacks. The simplest and most frequently deployed idea is to just include adversarial examples in the training set. This is called adversarial training and has some upsides, like that it not only enlarges the training set, but including adversarial examples in the training set leads to a more robust model against attack types it has seen during training. However, this is a heuristic defense, meaning that this defense measure might perform well in defending some kind of attacks, but there is no theoretical guarantee for it. Adversarial training is one of the most successful heuristic defense. A certified defense, on the other side, provides certifications for the lowest accuracy they can reach under a very well-defined class of adversarial attacks. Recent approaches formulate an upper bound which guarantees that no attack under specific assumptions can surpass the certificated attack success rate. But certified defenses perform still worse than adversarial training. We observe how hard defenses are and how adversarial training relies on knowing what the attack is in order to have training examples addressing that kind of attack. Sadly, this is an arms race, as illustrated here by Miss Coffee Bean and her twin from another dimension. Attackers come up with methods of attack, and usually only afterwards the defenses can be formulated, especially if we use adversarial training as a defense mechanism. Only after the attackers raise the bar, the defenders respond, and so on. This dynamic will definitely make adversarial machine learning a dangerous, but technically engaging field. But while we are busy with technicalities, we should not forget to think about the ethical aspects. But this is a Pandora's box we will not open in this video, maybe in a future one. Instead, we'll leave you with this funny compilation of adversarial examples and neural network fails. See you in the next video!